for day to day. I don't know about the future, but I know who holds the future. I don't know what tomorrow holds. I can only be sure of this minute.
Yeah. changing me. Yes, God.
He must be getting me ready for something.
Because he fell.
chosen you to understand.
acontecendo. Is there anybody here?
When you come into a house of worship, there is a vision for that ministry.
Does that make sense?
They're expecting to accomplish something. And they're expecting to accomplish it in a certain way.
Does that make sense?
The Lord has given me to talk about the vision. Victory's vision. So that we can understand some things. Look at your neighbor and say, it's a holy vision.
It's a holy vision.
It's a holy vision. It was given to us by God. Amen. It's a vision to build the kingdom of God down here on earth. Amen. We've been all given a responsibility. And as we become members of a local assembly, we have been given the responsibility to help support and to build that local, amen, assembly in that part of the vineyard for the glory of God. Amen? I'm going to the book of Habakkuk, the second chapter. And I'm going to be reading verses 1 through 3. And in honor of the reading of the word, I ask everyone to stand. I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me. And what I shall answer when I am reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables or tablets, that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak, and not I. Though it tarry, do what?
Wait.
Wait for it. Because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Amen?
Amen?
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Write the vision. Amen. The first thing that God has given me to speak about, amen, and to make us aware of, amen, as we talk about the vision, amen, the first thing he says, speak about the watchmen or the watchers. Speak about those. And so he said, define vision. The faculty or state of being able to see. The ability to think about or plan the future with imagination and wisdom. Somebody say vision.
Vision.
And then watchmen, watching. Look at or observe attentively over a period of time. An act or instance of carefully observing someone or something over a period of time. Amen. Habakkuk, he was a prophet during about the 16th century. Not much is written about Habakkuk. We know about his hometown, we know nothing about his occupation, or even his tribe. According to the theologians, he is the eighth of the proposed 12 minor prophets. Now, when we talk about major prophets and minor prophets, the Bible didn't call them minor, and the Bible didn't call them major. We did that. Amen? We, for some reason, considered him to be, maybe because of the length of his book, a minor prophet. But anything that we do for God is not minor. Is that all right? The purpose of the book of Habakkuk. Habakkuk was asking God, how come bad people seem like they're always blessed and good people seem like they always have a hard time? Amen?
Amen.
And he wanted God to answer that question. He said, how long are you going to sit back and watch these guys prosper and we ain't getting nothing? We're supposed to be
your people. We're supposed to be your children. How many have asked that question? I'm doing the best that I can. I'm trying to live as holy as I can. It seems like trouble on every side. The mother said, how long do we have to put up with this? And then he said to the Lord, so now I'm going to stand up on this place, this high place, and see what you're going to say to me. And the Lord told them, you don't have to stay there long. Because you guys wasn't right, I'm going to have to punish you for your wrong. Sometimes we question the Lord, and he tells us we don't like it. Many times we forget the wrong that we did. We forget how we misbehaved. We forget how we were disrespectful. I wish somebody say amen now. And God reminded them of their bad behavior. Not only did he remind them of their bad behavior, he said it's not going to be long when the Babylonians are going to come and take you away for punishment's sake. That's why he told Habakkuk. He said, write the vision. Make it plain. Not that he who's going to run with the vision to do the vision, but they who are going to run for their very lives can at least read the vision. Because the nation of Israel was getting ready to run for their lives. He said, write it and make it plain. God had a plan for the nation of Israel to bring them back to where they belong. But sometimes coming back, people of God calls for a spanking. God don't only do a lasso, draw you in. Sometimes God allows some stuff to happen so that we can see how good God really is. Can I get a witness? And so God said, you're going to go into Babylonian captivity, but don't worry. You're going to come out of this. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm coming out. Come on, take it, I'm coming out of this.
I'm coming out of this.
We all have a vision of some sort. We have a vision for ourselves. When I was young, I truly wanted to sing secular music. Amen. I sang it for a long period of time. I enjoyed singing it. But the lifestyle is wrong. If I could sing secular music and didn't have to worry about cocaine, didn't have to worry about AIDS, didn't have to worry about peer pressure, because all of that was attached to it. Can I get a witness? If I could have done that, I might have stayed out there a little bit too long. We all have a vision for our lives. Some of us want husbands. Some of us want children. Some of our parents want to see their children get out of school and become responsible human beings. Yes. Some of us want to get along with our siblings. We all have a vision.
We all have a vision.
Amen.
The Lord said, tell the people about the watchman. A watchman is a person who keeps guard. Amen. To guard is to watch over in order to protect or control. Protect against damage or harm. The part of the vision that the Lord has given to this ministry, and I needed you to hear this, the part of the vision that the Lord has given to this ministry is to gather a team of believers together who are courageous, rambunctious, equipped, sold out enough to build a mighty ministry capable of being a viable force against any damage or harm to the kingdom of God. Together, a group, a team, not just people. Somebody say a team.
A team.
The whole idea of Victory Christian Ministries is not only to be a family, but to be a team. Because I know some families that don't work as a team. Can I get a witness? There are some families that don't get along with each other. There's some families who have not spoken to each other for years. That's not what I'm talking about. The Lord said, bring together a them to go forth and tell a dying world that don't even know that they're dying.
Wow.
Can I get a witness? When I was in the world, I didn't know that I was dying. In fact, I thought I was living, honey. I was living my life like it was golden. But I was going to hell in a handbasket.
Wow.
God said to bring together a group of people who are willing to be a team in the kingdom of God. Is there anybody in this room that want to be a team in the kingdom of God? I'm going to churches that don't like each other. I've been in churches where they talk about each other, where they talk down each other, where they talk down the ministry of God, where they talk down building the kingdom, and they only become a social club, where they come and meet with their friends and have a good time and go home and forget about the fact that somebody outside that door is dying, that somebody outside that door is involved in sin. And
tell us, Bishop.
Then the church is not concerned what you and how you live. I've been there. Anybody ever been there? Well, church, that's not this church.
That's not this church.
Amen.
That's not this place.
None.
This place is a team that God has strategically put together for the upbuilding of the kingdom of God and the tearing down of Satan's kingdom. Satan's kingdom must come down.
Must come down.
He said to bring together people of like precious faith. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
Do you believe that he lived and died and he walked on this earth and he did miracles? Do you believe that?
I believe it, Bishop.
Do you believe that he saved your soul, gave you the Holy Ghost, that you can become a witness of his works?
I believe it.
We just can't be a preaching and shouting church. The story of old Shouting John is a nice story. But we ain't just Shouting John.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
God has put something on the inside of this ministry. And as I begin to bring this to your mind, I want those who really believe it to stand up on your feet. The Lord said that he is putting together an exceeding great army in this ministry. Can I get a witness? Of people that don't mind fighting for the glory of God. Of people that don't mind going into battle and bringing down the works of the enemy in the lives of the people. Is there anybody in this house? word of God says, listen, and then I'm almost finished. Somebody hand me some water. We can never repay him.